Hello YouTube, welcome back to my videos. In this video I'm going to be creating this large chalk portrait of the Rock. And right there I was putting down some black tempera paint. It is a big necessity when working with chalk. And here I'm laying out a grid system. I use usually 6x6 squares, especially if I'm doing portraits. I like to keep it nice and tight. And here I'm sketching out the outlines. And I'll show you here on the iPad, I got X's in the squares, and that really helps me define the eyes, nose, and mouth. And I'll put these X's inside of my grid on the wall, and that will really help get the proportions right, especially if you're doing somebody that is very recognizable. The font is pretty simple. I'm just throwing up some words because it was kind of a big quote. And there you see the black and white. I like to do that, and that helps me get the values, and I go over it very lightly with some color. And then I'll just kind of blend that color in. If I'm not feeling that color, then I'll add a little more color to it, a different color. What I like to do is work multiple different colors. A little light touch, a little heavy touch. You just get the hang of it. I've been doing this for a few years, so I kind of got a real good feel for the medium. Chalk is very tricky, and it's very dirty. So if you're not afraid to get your hands dirty and not afraid to experiment, you could come up with some pretty awesome designs. Here I'm just kind of blending it using my hand. I'll scratch the chalk on there, and I'll take my hand and I'll rub it in until it's nice and smooth. It really makes that color pop. And I gotta stress the black tempera paint as a background, as a base coat, a primer. It works wonders for the chalk. And don't use Crayola chalk, it's the worst. There's no pigment in it. Artist soft pastels is the way to go, and I just use basic stuff. I mean, yeah, some is better than others. There's brands that are pretty expensive, and I use them sometimes. And most of the time I find myself using like a Koss brand or Blick. So I'm doing the background here, and I like to add a gradient, and I'm using purples. And you can see there's a white outline. That white really helps bring that portrait out of the background. It gives it some depth. That's just a personal touch I do. And I like to blend it in with my hand and go back over it. Blend it in, go back over it. You just gotta experiment. One of the important things for me is the eyes. If the eyes don't look like they're alive, then your whole piece is gonna look wrong. Concentrate on the eyes. The eyes tells the story. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. I'll be glad to answer anything. I'm thinking about doing a video on setting up a grid system. Once you understand a grid system, you can pretty much draw anything you want. Once you get the hang of using chalk, it can be a real joy to play with. Until next time, thanks a lot.